Hello, I'm Sin with the OSINT Dojo, and in this video, we're going to take a look at part two of my OSINT methodology for exploiting email addresses. If you haven't already watched part one of my email methodology, which focuses on content analysis, I've included the link in the description below. This part focuses on searches that I use whenever I come across an email address that I want to locate additional information about. While there are a number of additional OSINT tools and techniques that will apply to email addresses, I'm only going to cover those which I use as part of my standard checks. We're going to be using a generic test email so we don't inadvertently use someone else's real email address. You may have noticed that I cleared out quite a few of the tabs that we're opening. I don't have time to cover each and every tool that is involved. However, I am going to go over at least one from each section just to give you an idea of why I include them and what sort of information they might return. So, first off, I always run all emails through a number of basic search engines. At the absolute bare minimum, you should be covering the major ones such as Google and Bing, as each of them will display some slightly different results. If you are consistently getting no results, though, across different search engines, then you might want to remove the domain from the end of the email and simply search for the username portion instead. If you have a target that you believe to be in or from a non-English-speaking country, then I also recommend trying some of their native search engines as well. And though most emails I've queried don't usually have much of investigative value in the image search results, I do recommend checking those as well just to make sure you're covering all of your bases. Don't forget to also check a few dark web search engines as well, as you never know if the email you're looking for will be involved in a data breach or otherwise posted on a .onion site. While these results are usually very slim and quite heavy for false positives, you do occasionally locate a match, such as the one we can see right here. I also like to check for emails on specific data breach websites as well, such as Dehash, IntelligenceX, or Have I Been Pwned. Now, the goal here isn't to be nefarious, but we simply want to see which platforms had a data breach which might have included our target email. What this does is gives us an indication of what type of sites our target might be on, and lets us pinpoint what platforms we should direct our attention to later on during our investigation. Next up, I check email lookup tools such as That's Them or Malicious Data. Now, the results here tend to be hit and miss, but on occasion, you will find that someone uses an email address, and that somehow one of those many data brokers out there has tied it back to their real-world identity. Another way to locate the identity of the person behind an email is to simply search that email across different social media platforms, particularly those like LinkedIn, where the target may have also included other actionable information. Users may share their email in a comment or directly on their profile so that others can reach out to them. Keep in mind that depending on the search function of the site you're currently looking at, you might need to include your search string within quotes. Otherwise, you might just get hits on the domain in the email and not the full string that you're actually searching for. As you can see here, that's actually what's going on with Reddit. These results are only picking up on the domain of the email and not the full email string that we're looking for. You may also be able to obtain information on the person behind an email address by checking the email address in the public PGP Key Database. While users are not required to include any identifiable information when they create a PGP key, it is not entirely too uncommon for them to do so. So this is always some place that you should be sure to check. And finally, I also run all of my target email addresses through a search on Hooksy just to see if they've registered any domains under that email address. This can be a treasure trove of information that you can easily pivot off of, as it includes historical information as well. Couple this with something like the Internet Archive, and you can often go back into time and look at what are now defunct websites that your target previously owned.